Ja, hallo zusammen, liebes Espresso-TV-Publikum. Jetzt haben wir hier noch einen besonderen Leckerbissen. Und zwar gibt es ja im Internet immer die Diskussion über den Pumpendruck. Sollen es jetzt 9 bar sein oder höher oder vielleicht niedriger? Aus dem Grund haben der Luca Betzerer und ich Kleinigkeit zusammengestellt, um einfach das zu verdeutlichen, wo der optimale Pumpendruck bzw. Brühdruck liegt für die Espresso-Maschinen, professionell und semi-professionell. Hi, dear Espresso Freaks. Now we are dealing about a subject discussed in the internet of the right pump pressure, either 9 bar or higher or lower or whatever. And this is always depending on the machine type. And let's have a look what Luca Bezzera is saying about this. Yeah, let's look.
So you have the pressure of the boiler that we set 1.1, 1.2 bar, and it's different from the pressure of the coffee. It's just the pressure that is kept at the boiler. And when you press the coffee button, you have the other pressure that is the pressure of the pump. So this pump is set in the professional machine at 9 bar. In the small semi-professional machine with the small motor pump, we set at 11 bar because this pump is 100 liter per hour capacity. The small pump is 34 liter capacity. So we give a little bit more power and we increase of a couple of bar pressure. And on the internet there is a big discussion in between this because a lot of people pretend to have the home use coffee machine with the small vibration pump at 9 bar like we used to set the professional machine, but it's completely different.
Okay.
But people read the history of the coffee. So in, I think, 1930, Mr. Achille Gaggia put the first pump of the coffee machine set at 9 bar. So people still want to do like what this, but with a completely different system because he was using a professional pump like this one.
Also was wir jetzt gehört haben, mit Vibrationspumpen 9 bar macht absolut keinen Sinn. Die sind eher bei 10 bis 11 bar anzusiedeln und ja.
For example, to explain you the difference, this is the big pump, the professional one we set at 9 bar. Come with me, I show you.
So, das war jetzt die professionelle Rotationspumpe, jetzt kommen wir zu den kleinen Vibrationspumpen. So Martin, hier sehen wir jetzt die kleine Vibrationspumpe.
This is the small vibration pump.
Ulka, und das ist ja klar, dass so kleine Pumpe ein bisschen mehr Druck braucht als jetzt eine große Pumpe, die wesentlich mehr Förderleistung hat. Das ist praktisch der ganze Hintergrund der Sache. Also dieses 9 Bar Geschwätz ist einfach albern.
When they have applied, come please. When they have installed the first pump and set the 9 bar, it was completely different from this small plastic pump. You imagine that this small red item make the function of the motor and of the pump. Also, if you now he switch it on, if you hear the noise, it's good. It's done to work with the small machine, but it's a weak pump compared to the other one.
So that's it needs more less pressure.
Yeah.
Or more pressure.
More pressure.
More pressure.
And here is the same. You have a small control board, two probe to keep the lever in the boiler. And when you activate the push button, you open a freeway solenoid valve and the pump starts to push to make the coffee. You see?
Yes, it mess. Yeah.
It's just a it's like a toy, so you have to increase a little bit the pressure. That's why we insist, also on internet, also people say, no, the small machine 9 bar. No, it's better to increase it. And it's not just, now, also on the Illy website, that is one of the biggest roasters we have in Italy, they suggest to go 9 or more bar. Because with those machines, with such a small pump, you need to have a little bit more power. Yeah.
Also bei so einer kleinen Vibrationspumpe braucht man einfach ein bisschen mehr Druck als die 9 bar.
Das ist was ganz anderes wie mit so einer fetten Rotationspumpe. Da sind die 9 Bar richtig, aber bei einer kleinen Vibrationspumpe sind 11 Bar einfach viel effizienter, um einen gescheiten Espresso rauszukriegen.
You are comparing this?
Jetzt, Martin, jetzt guck mal.
You are comparing.
Die fette Pumpe hier.
This?
Der, das ist die fette Pumpe zu der hier. Zu der
to
hier.
This.
Hier. Also das hier ist unser kleiner David, der muss halt mit 11 Bar arbeiten. Und hier haben wir unseren Goliath. Hier fette Rotapumpe und die schafft halt nur mit 9 Bar.